Hi everyone, let's learn how to make spinning objects in PowerPoint. Here's how to do it. First, choose the type of object you're going to spin, then create shading, and finally, animate your object. Now before we begin, let me just explain the two types of options for the spinning effect. The first is what I call the text option. Use this if you want to write something that's spinning around the object, as you saw earlier, for example, with the Christmas ornament and the ball in the intro video. The second is the picture or pattern option. Use this if you have some sort of design, such as the world map that you'd like to spin around. So this one wouldn't include text. I'll start by showing you all the steps for the text option, and then we'll move on to the picture option. To give you a quick look of how to do the spinning text, let me first sort of deconstruct or pull apart what I did for the first section for that red ball. The ball part is covered up on all sides by black, so let me move that away so that you can see it better. Basically, what's happening is that there's a wheel of text that's rotating to create the spin effect. There's also some shading in there to give it a 3D look. And I'll just manually rotate the text here so you can see how it works. All right, so let me put everything back together really fast and we'll start over and show it to you from the very first step. So now that we've chosen the text option, we now need to create a rectangle with a circle cut out of it. I'll call this the window layer, for lack of a better word. I've inserted a white rectangle here on top of our orange background, and now I'll add a circle on top of that. And make sure the circle doesn't have an outline. Now, of course, if you have PowerPoint 2013, it's very simple to combine these shapes by selecting both the circle and rectangle, and under the Format tab, clicking on Combine Shapes, those two circles there, then Combine. And there you go. If you have an earlier version of PowerPoint, I'll just show you really fast how to do it since I know I'll get questions on it. You just highlight both shapes, cut them by right-clicking or Control X on a PC, then paste as a picture, then go to your color options, choose Set Transparent Color, click on the circle, and there you go. You have a perfect cutout. Okay. Now that we've made the window layer one way or another, let's make the text part. I'll just create a text box and put some test words in there. Now I'll go to Word Art Styles and choose this half circle here. Increase the size, make it a little bit more circular, and adjust it so that it looks the way that you want in your window. Make sure that the height and width are the same so it's a perfect square. And now I'll just bring the window layer to the front and make the text white and also bold so that it looks better on the orange background. We now have our ball and the text done, but it currently looks kind of like a flat circle, which is why the next step of creating shading is so important because it'll give it more of that 3D look. To create shading, we first create a circle about the same size as our cutout and take out the outline. Now make it a gradient fill, make it a radial gradient, and start it from the center. And even though this isn't an exact science, I'll show you at least one set of parameters that worked for me. For the first color, make it the color of the background. The position is 4% and the transparency is 100%. The next color is in a 30% position. Make it the same orange color as before, and transparency is 90%. Next, we have one in the position of 96% and transparency of 0. And make the color for this one dark gray. And the last one is in position 100%, is black, and also has a transparency of 0. And actually, I'm not sure if this last one really matters to put in there, but I like to do it anyway. Now bring the window layer to the front just to make sure the shading stays within the boundaries of the original circle. And we're just gonna add another shading piece now on top of that. So add another circle, take out the outline again, go back to gradient fill, and let's change up these numbers. First off, make this a path gradient instead of a radial gradient, and that's a really important point. Now make it just 2 points on either side, both the left side and the right side. Make them both white, so really easy. Now the first one on the left is 50% transparent, and the second one is 100% transparent. This gives you a nice subtle reflection or glare on the shape. And you can stop here, but I personally like to make a copy of that last shading piece and make it a little bit smaller in size and put it on top of the first one right there. And there you go. It looks a lot less flat than before. And feel free, of course, to use your own shading techniques. I am not a shading expert at all, so I'm sure if you're at all artistic, you can create a much more complex and realistic looking shading pattern than I have here. But this should get you started, especially if you're a beginner. So let's now move to the final step of animating your object. So for this step, let's bring up our animation pane first. Then highlight the text and just choose the spin animation. Make sure that it's set to clockwise, or at least if you're using a language that's read left to right, like English. And let's also increase the time to 15 seconds so that it spins slower. And here's the result. And obviously, if you were to do this, you wouldn't have any gaps around the edges of the window layer like I have here. I was just doing that to show you how it works behind the scenes. Okay, so now let's move on to the picture or pattern option. And I'll show you how to do the rotating world. For this, we'll start with the same window layer as we had before. It's already pre-made, but on a blue background this time. Now we add the world map picture. And the picture must be rectangular. It can't be one of those maps that looks like an oval. And this map in particular has a transparent background, but that's entirely optional. You can have any map that's a rectangle. In fact, let me go to Google Images really fast just to show you the types of maps that would work for this. Of course, with any image, make sure you have the right to use it, but I'm just showing you these to give you an idea of what types of images would work. So this one would work, and that one too, and even the one under it, even though I'm not crazy about those colors. Okay, in any case, this is the one that we're going to use. Let's just put the window layer to the front, and now we'll create our gradient. For this, make a square. Then take out the outline and change it to a gradient fill. Make it radial and start from the center. And I'll talk you through the rest of the numbers again. First, let's make all the colors here black. And for the first one that's all the way to the left, make the transparency 100%. Put the next one at position 45% and set the transparency to 50%. Next one is at 70% position and 7% transparency, then 85% position and 2% transparency. Now, again, this is just my way of doing it, so feel free to play around with these numbers so that the gradient looks the way that you want it to. Now we actually tilt the square to the side so that we have a little bit more dark area on the right to work with, and you can make it a little bit bigger as well. Okay, now we can move on to the animation, which is a little bit harder than the text option, but the effect is well worth it. So first, let's bring the world map to the front again so that we can work with it. Now duplicate it by selecting the map and hitting Control D on a PC or just copy and pasting. Now line up the copied picture exactly on the left side of the original, since our map will be spinning to the right or counterclockwise. If your picture will be moving to the left, put its copy on the right. So the opposite of what you're seeing here. Now group the two pictures, the original and the duplicate, and go to the animations and choose a linear motion path and set it to go to the right. Go to the effect options and take out smooth start and end. Go to timing and make it spin for 3 seconds and make it repeat until the end of the slide. Okay, now this is where it gets a little hard, so try to pay attention carefully. Stretch the motion path so that it goes exactly to the end of the original picture. No more, no less. In PowerPoint 2013's preview, it's easier because you can see the pictures kind of like line up on top of each other. As a tip, if you're on a PC, hold down shift while you stretch the motion path to make sure that the motion path remains straight. And when you're done, your motion path should be exactly the length of one picture. So just keep adjusting it until it's perfect or else it won't work right. So to finish this off, let me send the map part to the back and let me clean up these edges really fast by putting black on top of them so that the graphic looks nice and neat. And let's test this out. Looks really cool. Now you may be wondering how I did the more complicated world that was in the intro video. Let me also deconstruct that for you quickly, and it's the same exact principles as I just showed you, but it just has a lot more layers of shading, as you can see here. And I also used a pre-made picture and cut out the world part by putting a circle on top of it, pasting as a picture, and setting the circle to be transparent, sort of like what I showed you earlier in this video. So that's all I got. Hopefully you like this technique, and honestly, it's a really useful one to spice up your presentation and truly delight your audience. So enjoy and let me know how you like it. Thanks for watching and see you again soon.